Are you looking for an accurate, easy, and less time-consuming way to fit test your employees' respirators? This video compares the two available respirator fit testing methods, quantitative and qualitative, as described by OSHA, and shows how quantitative methods allow you to provide a more beneficial fit test in less time. Before diving into the fit test comparison, let's review a few basics on how these methods work. Qualitative fit testing is a subjective fit test method, meaning that the result is a pass or fail based on the self-reported feedback of the respirator wearer. Qualitative fit testing uses a challenge agent such as saccharin or Bitrex and the respirator wearer's sense of taste to determine if the respirator has a good fit. If the fit is poor, the respirator wearer will taste the challenge agent during testing. If at the completion of the test, the challenge agent is not tasted, the test is passed. Quantitative fit testing is an objective testing method, meaning that the test returns data on the measurements taken. The quantitative instrument shown in this video, the PortaCount Fit Tester Model 8048, takes measurements of the particle concentrations both within and outside of the respirator. Those two measurements create a ratio called a fit factor. Measurements are taken continually throughout the test, and a fit factor is calculated for each exercise and at the completion of the test. This final fit factor is compared to established guidance for respirator types, resulting in a passed or failed fit test. For this comparison, we will show you a successful fit test with each method on an N95 filtering face piece. To begin, for the qualitative methods only, a threshold screening is required to evaluate the respirator wearer's sensitivity to the challenge agent. 10 nebulizer squeezes are introduced to the hood worn by the individual who is not yet wearing the respirator. If the individual can't sense the challenge agent in the first 10 squeezes, 20 and then 30 are tried. The challenge agent is not sensed after 30 squeezes, another challenge agent must be used. The threshold at which the challenge agent is detected is noted and determines the number of nebulizer squeezes used during the fit test exercises. The threshold testing takes approximately 1 to 3 minutes and is followed by approximately 10 minutes or more of wear-off time before the fit test is started. To prepare respirator wearers for the fit test, with each method, the respirator wearer must complete a seal check, then a comfort assessment by donning their respirator and wearing it for 5 minutes to allow it to properly seat and seal to the face and gauge comfort. For pre-test steps, we estimate a total time for the qualitative method at approximately 16 to 18 minutes. For quantitative fit testing with the PortaCount instrument, the only pre-test step is 5 minutes for the comfort assessment. The two testing methods we are comparing use different OSHA protocols. The qualitative fit testing protocol requires 7 60-second exercises, totaling for 7 minutes. The quantitative protocol used by PortaCount instruments requires only 4 exercises of varying length, totaling 2 minutes and 29 seconds. Let's see how these two fit testing methods compare. For the qualitative testing method, the fit test starts with 60 seconds of normal breathing. For the quantitative method using the PortaCount Fit Tester, the fit test starts with 50 seconds of bending over and returning to an upright position, taking 2 breaths at each extreme. For the qualitative fit test, the number of nebulizer squeezes noted from the threshold or sensitivity test are introduced at the beginning of each exercise, followed by half that number of nebulizer squeezes every 30 seconds. This results in between 105 and 315 nebulizer squeezes per test. For the quantitative test, the respirator wearer simply follows the on-screen animations to complete the exercise. The instrument automatically takes measurements, calculates a fit factor for each exercise, and records the results. As the first exercise for the quantitative method is shorter, the second exercise of talking for 30 seconds now begins. For the qualitative method, the second exercise is deep breathing for 60 seconds. While the relative timing of each method is the most obvious difference, this is only part of the story. With quantitative fit testing, you get objective results that provide data on a respirator's fit and performance throughout the fit test. With this information, you can better ensure that respirators will fit and protect your employees in real-world conditions. Qualitative fit testing simply cannot provide the same insights you gain with a quantitative fit test. Here, we move on to the third exercise for the quantitative fit test, 30 seconds of head side to side with 2 breaths at each extreme. Meanwhile, the qualitative fit test needs an additional 40 seconds to complete the second exercise. It's important to note that quantitative instruments can provide assistance beyond the fit test. The PortaCount instrument allows you to use real-time measurements to help better select respirators for employees, train them how to don and adjust them for maximum protection, and troubleshoot any fit test failures that may occur. With the qualitative fit test still completing exercise 2, the quantitative fit test moves on to the fourth and final exercise, 39 seconds of head up and down with 2 breaths at each extreme. Now the qualitative test moves into exercise 3, 60 seconds of moving the head side to side. The PortaCount fit tester reduces the fit test down to just 4 exercises and a total test time that is nearly 65% shorter than the qualitative fit test protocol. After just 2 minutes and 29 seconds, the quantitative fit test is complete. The screen displays the results for each exercise, the final fit factor, and the result of a past fit test. The qualitative fit test still needs to complete the third exercise, followed by another 4 exercises, a minute each of head up and down, talking, bending over or jogging in place, and normal breathing. Keep in mind, the fit tester will need to squeeze the nebulizer 10 to 30 times at the beginning of each exercise, and then half that amount every 30 seconds. In total, a single correctly performed qualitative fit test takes approximately 23 to 25 minutes per fit test. For a quantitative fit test using a PortaCount instrument, the total time for a fit test, including the comfort assessment period, is 7 minutes and 29 seconds. Let's say you need to fit test 100 people. You could save nearly 26 hours of fit testing time, or over 3 8-hour workdays by using the PortaCount fit tester. PortaCount instruments provide users with objective results, a quicker fit test, and automated testing and record keeping. But more importantly, for respirator wearers, quantitative fit testing with PortaCount instruments enables you to verify with data that the employees have been provided the right respirator, they know how to wear them, and that their respirators will provide protection to the level expected if worn properly. The PortaCount fit tester allows you and your employees to be confident in their fit and protection. Thank you for joining us. For more information on respirator fit testing and the PortaCount respirator fit tester, see our other videos or visit tsi.com/PortaCount.